Hey, how's it going, guys? My name is Jackie Fish, and welcome back to the Last Alliance Total War. The Elves have invaded Middle-earth, and I cannot wait to show them off because they look absolutely amazing. So the next installment of the Last Alliance campaign is here. I'll link it down below in the description. I believe it's not out right now, but it will be out in the next week or so. So definitely go check that out. I'll also go ahead and leave a link to their Discord if you want to keep up to date. Generally, that's the best way to keep up to date with most mods, is just to join their Discord and kind of keep an eye on that. It's generally what I tend to do. They always post really cool update videos as well, so you kind of get a little bit of taste before you see a video like this. So yeah, if you've never heard of the Last Alliance Total War, this is a mod for Shogun 2 Total War that goes ahead and brings the Second Age alive. At the moment, they just have a prologue campaign, but I believe inevitably what they want to do when they have more of the factions in the game is kind of sink Numenor and just have Middle-earth and kind of play out the battle of the Second Age and the war of, you know, the war of the Second Age, which will be really, really exciting. Obviously, Numenor has not been sunk yet, has not been deceived, and at this point in the prologue campaign, you can play on Numenor, you can take command of them and try and overthrow the current, you know, the true ruler, the queen who doesn't abdicate. It's a really, really exciting war if you do want to fight for Numenor. And there's already several factions in the mod. As you can see, obviously, we have the Kingdom of Numenor. We have a few of these Numenorian colonies that kind of scatter out throughout the coastline of Gondor and up the coastline in the north. And then you also have the new elves, which have just recently been added in this update. And then you have a few of the Harad tribes as well. So let's jump in and we'll take a look at the elven start position, because it's really, really cool. They have a pretty strong kingdom. I'm not sure if the modder plans on breaking up the elves at all, or at least these elves. Obviously, there are going to be several other elven factions in the mod itself. And what I'll do, actually, I'll post up on screen right now the actual dev plans. If you kind of are interested, like maybe you're a real big fan of the dwarves and you're like, whenever dwarves are going to play, or whenever dwarves are going to get added, I'm not going to play probably until then you can see right here. Right now, we are obviously on the elves in the top left. You can see that the elves in the current version, that's kind of the next big update will be coming out very, very soon. And then as you can see going across, I think after this planned update, the main focus is going to be on getting the kind of the what is Gondor and Rohan in the mod, along with Mordor, which I think will be a great installment, because kind of, you know, once you've kind of got this left-hand side filtered out, getting in like kind of what is Gondor and Rohan in the Third Age, as well as Mordor, you kind of have a lot of major powers. And I'm really looking forward to see what the modder does with the orcs as well, because that's going to be epic, having orcs finally in the mod going to war with the elves and the, you know, the men of Numenor. Oh, it's going to be great. I really, really can't wait. And you can obviously see the other versions as well. Obviously, the higher the version number is kind of going to be the next update. So yeah, that's a little kind of idea of when the modder is planning on adding in those things. And yeah, it's really exciting. This is one of a mod I always follow closely. I always check the Discord, so it's great to see that the update is coming along. So yeah, here we go. This is going to be the Elven capital right here in North Mithlon, up here, all the way up in the north. You can see the territory. We're all basically in the top. This map is a little bit messed up. It doesn't quite go quite to where we are, but we're obviously, you know, all the way up here at the moment, as you can see. And yeah, so right off the bat, we have really cool buildings. I'm a huge fan of these new custom artwork for the building trees. I feel like the Shogun build tree is sometimes a little bit confusing and overwhelming, but the new unit cards for the buildings are absolutely great. And again, I really love the building province system in Shogun 2, where you have all these resources, which are like separate towns scattered throughout the terrain. It's really nice. And obviously you can see there are plenty of upgrades, but you can go ahead and improve your stuff, and obviously you can continue to upgrade your markets, your weaponry, you can build better units and improve your soldiers that way. And as you can see, the majority of the elven land is going to be scattered for along the coastline. You have a lot of territory before hitting into the Numenorians down here to the south, so we're kind of like, this is the bottom of the territory. And then you also go all the way up across in the north as well, holding a large amount of this territory kind of surrounding the Brelands and the Shire and stuff like that. You obviously also have inland as well, all the way over in the far right hand side, obviously Rivendell as we know and love, and the Misty Mountains going down here. So yeah, if we take a look at the overall map as well, you can see that a lot of the map has already been filled in with certain factions. I believe these factions were added in this update, like kind of essential. So you have the men of Mephrath, I think is how you pronounce that. You got the Brelanders as well, Bree right here. The Shire is like, yeah, somewhere around here. So you also have a few kind of other minor settlements that have been added. I'm not sure what the units are actually like for these factions, if they're actually blocked in or what they actually are. They probably are just new Norians right now, and then they'll get their own custom units going forward. Again, obviously, you're going to have a load of different types of units as well. You can see some of the Noldrin swords right to, or spears right here, along with the archers and the general units, but we'll see all of that when we actually dive into the battle. As well as that, if you go to diplomacy, you can kind of get a good idea as well about who you're going to be friends with. Obviously, you're pretty friendly with the Breland to begin with, very friendly with Numenor as well, or at least the northern Norman, at least the northern kingdom of Numenor as well. And as well as that, whilst we're on the campaign map, we might as well show it off so you can see kind of all the rest of the campaign map going down. Obviously, we are now in the Thieves of Gondor as we go across and all these kingdoms. So these are obviously Numenorean colonies right now at Pelagir. We don't quite go any further north, so we don't go into Minas Tirith or anything up here, but this is obviously planned for the next update, well after the elves have been done and fleshed out and, you know, have a little bit more work done to them. And then obviously all of this will be filled in. So you can see right now it's just barren wasteland, but, you know, we'll start to get more and more content in here. Obviously, we'll get the elves up here in Mirkwood and other stuff like that, which will be cool. And obviously, the forces of Mordor. Obviously, as you go down as well, you can see that the lands to the south are pretty populated, and Harad have a very, very cool tree as well. They have a lot of units, which again, we can fight against Harad because they're a very, very fun faction. And you can see there's a lot of land down here, a lot of different factions, a lot of settlements. Obviously, ships aren't done quite yet, but hopefully, or aren't done and aren't planned to be done for a long time, but, you know, inevitably they will be. So yeah, you can see, you know, the map is very vast already. You can definitely have a fun campaign. Obviously, you have Numenor as well, all the way out here as well, something I didn't even show, which I assume inevitably will be sunk for the main grand campaign, but in the prologue campaign, it isn't. So you can even just have a fun campaign on Numenor, honestly, without even having to worry about anything else. But yeah, I imagine inevitably, obviously, when we get, you know, a few more, you get Mordor filled in and, like, kind of a lot of this land filled in, the campaign will be feel extremely well done. But obviously, right now, you can have a very fun campaign. Obviously, there's not really a lot of evil factions to be fighting right now, but hopefully in the next big update there will be. So cool, let's go ahead and jump into the battles, and we'll take a look at the units, the new elven units that that have been added into the game. Okay, so here we go. We are now in the custom battle screen, and you can see some of the units that I'm going to be bringing. If I go to the modify army, you can see everything that the elves have available to them. They're obviously going to be heavily focused on their spears and their archers, having the spear line defend the front line whilst the archers go to town and shoot at everything. You have the ability to pick two generals, the High King's Guard and the Noldor Guard as well. You have four different variants of spearmen, ranging from, I guess, light spears to extremely heavy spears in the Noldor spearmen. You also only have one unit of sword infantry. These guys are going to be, I think it's a light axe infantry. Yeah, a Sindar light axe infantry. So again, nothing going to be like, you know, winning you the battles, but, you know, still a very good unit to try and outflank. Then you obviously your meat is going to be in your archers and your spears. Like I said, you have some of the Noldor spears, you have some of the Teller archers, as well as a much lighter archer unit again over here on the left hand side. And then you have two variants of cavalry. You have a heavy shot cavalry in these Noldor lancers, and then you also have this lighter archer right here as well. So I tried to bring, I think I did actually bring every single unit that I do have available, so you guys can see that in all its glory. We're going up against the Harad force, which is pretty scary. Quite a few of their soldiers are going to get stuck in. So let's just dive into this battle. I shouldn't have to make a cut here because it should load fairly quickly, and then we'll take a look at all the units and all the cool new designs. I believe there is also some siege equipment being added in as well for this, whether it's ballistas or I'm not actually sure. Yeah, I think it's ballistas that are being added in for the elves, which is going to be really cool because, you know, there is no siege equipment in Shogun 2. So again, all of that is going to have to be, you know, made from scratch, which is one of the really impressive things about this mod is, you know, there's no shields in Shogun 2. So they've had to create custom shield animations and interactions. And when you kind of, you know, it might not sound like it will be that much work, but when you have to kind of consider how many different weapons there are in the game and how many different animations and how each of them can have, you know, so many different combinations, it kind of gets a bit crazy. It really does. So let's just set up our line. We'll have the spear, the elite spears on the front line, we'll have these spears on the left, we'll have the lighter spears on the right, we'll have the kind of really light spears in the center, like so. We'll have our archers set up here, then our crappier archers just in front of them, cavalry on either flank, then we still have these light swords, which I guess we'll stick the light swords over the axes, I should say, on either flank, and our general, boom, back right in the middle. Okay, let's take a look at these bad boys. Let's see what the elves are all made of. Oh my god, they look amazing. This is the first time I'm properly seeing them. They look great. Like, Shogun 2 is such an old game. It's literally like a 10-year-old game. And I mean, that looks amazing. That really does look great. The modder has definitely outdone themselves. The spears as well, you guys can see that. Really, really nice stuff. So that's just like kind of the first basic unit. Well, again, not basic unit. And I love the flags as well. Shogun 2 is such a good flag system. I mean, that's my thumbnail right there, I think. Maybe I'll try and get a bit of a brighter one. But yeah, look at that shield as well. That shield is so nice. Oh, God. Shogun 2 is great. Are the enemy coming at me or do I have to go to them? Just making sure I'm not going to get attacked immediately. I think we got some time. So then as we go further back, we do have the lighter spears. These are the Tellarai Spearmen. Or spearmen and women. These guys are... Yeah, they got kind of curved blades. More round shields with the symbol on. A bit more heavily armored. And they can also form a pike wall as well. Or a yari wall, it's called at the moment. That looks really cool. What does this look like when we form the... Oh, that looks good. That looks so dope. And again, all custom animations. Obviously, there are no spears in the game. So you just got to keep that in mind. You got to tell yourself that whenever you're seeing this. Like, this is all really cool stuff. Indeed. So that's going to be that. And as we go further back, well, I guess we'll go on the flanks and we'll see the other spearmen. So these, are, I guess, are going to be the much lighter spearmen. You can see their chest armor is, yeah, a lot lighter. You know, not as heavily as the proper Noldrin spearmen. Still, really, really cool unit on this left-hand side. Very, very nice indeed. Then we've obviously also got the axes. So again, a light moving kind of shock infantry. And kind of see that custom well-made blade. And the warriors looking very scary indeed. Really love the detail in the shields as well. That's really, really cool indeed. Let's go back. We have some of the skirmisher cavalry as well. Actually, might even just send these gals out there to start harassing the enemy. So obviously just a light unit of archers, but able to do a decent amount of damage, I'm sure. Then if we go back, we can see the super light archers right here. So these are the, I guess, the basic tier archers for the elves. Nothing too special, but still a unit, I'm sure, to be reckoned with. Then we have kind of the medium tier archers, again. And obviously also as well, if you haven't heard it. Obviously that is from Battle for Middle-earth. So if anyone's getting the nostalgia hit right now, that is where a lot of these voice lines are from, which is awesome. I love Battle for Middle-earth. And then we have the beautiful last unit of the elite elves right here. This is obviously going to be the top tier archers. I imagine these guys are going to fire so fast. They can deploy stakes. They can second wind, flaming arrows and whistling arrows. Can't wait to see these guys just unload hell. They probably fire extremely fast. So again, that's going to be the elite unit. And I think we just have the King's Bodyguard back here. Oh, that's so beautiful. That is so nice. And that silver armor, the shields and the helmets. Yeah, that looks good. That definitely looks very, very good. The elves are, yeah, looking spectacular. Look at that. That is just amazing. It really is. Yeah, Shogun 2, just to this day, looks great. It really, really does. And then obviously, finally, we have the cavalry up on this left-hand side. This is the last unit we need to look at. Again, looking very solid. They've kind of got the lighter elven armor on, obviously, being on horseback. So cool, let's see what they're made of in combat. So let's, I guess we're going to just group everyone, because I can't remember how to actually move units not in a group. So let's just, oh, this is a really bad formation. Can we just, like, move here? Oh my god, what the hell is that formation? Oh god. Probably because you guys are not here. If I get rid of you guys, nope. And then group these guys. This is a crash course. There we go. It's because I have the other unit of cavalry deployed. So if we just sit up there, we'll be fine. We'll set up some of these horse archers. Let's see what they are made of. And we'll get these guys out of pike wall as well so that they don't end up delaying the rest of the group. So you guys, can you guys fire and move out of interest? Or we're taking some missile fire. I just want to see if... Oh my god. What the hell are they just firing fire arrows at me? Oh, brutal. Can you guys shoot and move? Or is that not something that you can do? Yeah, I was like, do they have, like, rockets or something? Oh, they can shoot and move. That is awesome. Are we on slow-mo and watch that? But, oh, the fire arrow is coming in as well. I forget how great Shogun 2 is when it comes to graphics. Like, it still just looks amazing. I want to see them, like, volley in. It reminds me of, like, The Hobbit when you see the Noldrin elves moving in. I'm just going to go to the woods, take some protection in there, get behind the enemy. We can come back to them a little bit later. I'm sure. Let's get back onto normal speed. Rest of our infantry is just moving into position. Again, we have that huge range on the Elven archers, so that's obviously what we want to utilize. Once again, we just select the whole of this group, get it up a little bit again. I guess up to like here on this hill would be great. So we'll run out there and we'll form like a nice little shield wall. And we'll go from there. Keep on moving this cavalry around, just kind of keep them a bit busy. Oh yeah, and also again, if you want to take a look at some of the Harad units as well, like amazing. If we take a look at maybe some of our frontline units, obviously we'll see a lot more of these guys when we do get stuck in against them, but again, they look great. Really, really nice stuff. And again, their cavalry looks awesome. Like seeing like heavy armored cataphracts in Shogun 2 is kind of crazy. The AI is really reforming, but my archers are going to soon be in range. So I hope you guys like being crispy, because the archers are going to unleash hell upon you. These ones are already getting ready to fire. And again, the Shogun 2 missile system is like one of the most beautiful missile systems in any Total War. The way the arrows just glide and then hit their target, they haven't managed to do it justice as well as they have in Shogun 2, like ever. Like the way the arrows just kind of glide in and then hit their target, like, it's literally beautiful. It really is. I mean, right now we are just hitting what, some Triton Slingers. Oh, the arrows just finding that mark, guys, brutal. And look how fast these elves shoot as well. That is deadly. These archers aren't shooting, though. Wonder why not. I'll put you there, and I'll put you over here. I mean, obviously, we're just going to sit back and use our missiles to our advantage. We're not really in range of anything else too valuable, so I guess we have to kind of maybe edge forward just a tad. We'll do that. This cavalry can start coming around. We'll just edge forward just a little bit, just so our main archer line is in range. Because I imagine our range is so much better. We have 240 range. I imagine they have nowhere near that much. We'll let the archers continue to shoot. Well, again, we're just killing some more of these slingers. I mean, look how much damage they are taking as well. As brutal as the arrow volleys come in. Oh, and the over-the-top Shogun 2 blood as well. We can also fire arrow as well if we wanted to. Stick on fire. It does shorten our range, but it shouldn't be too much, actually. Some soldiers on that flank. I might dispatch my right flank just to get stuck in. See what that's made of. We have swords on this flank as well. Yeah, we could really close in the distance. What we probably want to do as well is we want to also form up in a nice little tight shield wall there. I can't imagine these axes can do very well. So actually, we're just going to push these axes forwards to get them stuck in. Push the enemy back a little bit. Let the archers just continue to volley off. I mean, that just looks so goddamn good, doesn't it? That really, really does. Amazing. And our swords are pushing forward. I imagine they are going to try and fall back. But if we can catch a bunch of their soldiers here, we're also rapid advance. So we'll be super fast. And we'll just get stuck in on these archers. Why not? So again, all the animations you are seeing have been added. Well, majority of the animations you will be seeing have all been added in custom made. Because obviously there's no shield animation. There's no axes. There's, you know, there are obviously sword animations. But again, a lot of them are going to be, you know, replaced out. As the men fight over the fish and the lamppost. They still have some archers though shooting down on my line. We also have this cavalry, which I guess we'll send round as well. How's the rest of our battle line doing? I mean, we are decimating the enemy. And again, one of the great things that you will be able to see is that there will be a campaign. There will be a multiplayer campaign as well. Shogun 2 is really the first proper multiplayer campaign series. So you'll be able to see that as well. This is kind of, Shogun 2 was like really the first proper one after Napoleon. You can just see the elves marching forward. Let's see one with a decent, where's the flag? Flag is a little bit more buried. But you can see them marching up. A staunch line of spears. Pushing on the enemy as the elven archers continue to unleash volley after volley. Don't worry, we've got this. Don't you worry. The battle will be won with all glory and honor. We're just going to get ourselves stuck in. And again, oh, actually got some cavalry fighting up in the distance. And I didn't think I fared too well in that fight. You got a cataphract charge against us. So I can't imagine our cavalry does that good over there. We have some cavalry getting fought over here as well. Well, yeah, we basically just need to charge in then. Let's just get everyone stuck in and try and overrun their position. It seems like they have a lot more missiles than I thought I gave them, which is fine. But we're just going to have to do a little bit of microing now to make sure we don't win. Let's reinforce this left-hand side, because that seems like it's the side that's on the most problem. We'll bring up some archers. Again, we'll just continue to focus down their missiles. Let's just kind of focus down a bit more that they have. And we also have some more spearmen over here as well. Obviously, dealing with the cavalry is going to be important. And you can see the lines pushing up again, just being fully up and not engaging. So cavalry just gets a nice charge off against me here. That's not good. These spears need to get themselves stuck in immediately, because they just charge my light infantry, and that's just not going to stand. So let's throw in our spears to see if we can turn the tide of this battle. Let's slow up the camera a little bit. Look at them arrows. I love the arcing shots of the arrows. It's just so beautiful. It really is. We'll just go down the battle line. And you guys can see as arrows go flying past. I'm actually focusing down my general a lot. I should probably either get him stuck in combat or retreat him. As more and more soldiers are now throwing themselves into the main fight. Let's speed up the camera again. And yeah, I think we're actually going to have to get our general fully stuck in before he ends up getting killed or something. We have a few positions. Hold firm. Let's stick that down. The archers should be decimating their missiles. We are doing a very good job of killing their missiles. That left flank is being lost pretty heavily. They're pushing in quite hard there. We need to try our best to overrun them here. If we can help it. We are far. Look at that glaive infantry. These are the desert warriors I'm now fighting. I've only got my lighter spears engaging them. My archers still have plenty of ammo left as well, which is really strong. There's just so many of them. There really is a lot of the enemy. They've got a nice little hybrid unit here as well. This unit is, I guess, missiles and also spears. They look great. The helmet designs are awesome. And also, I love the spears as well, but that's really, really cool. Okay, what can we do here now? We've got another unit of spare spears here. I guess we'll bring them around the flank. That's not good, but it's not good. Don't worry, I'm doing... Oh, that's really nice as well in Shogun 2. When your unit runs out of ammunition, it moves to a separate group. I guess that could be kind of annoying, but I think it's cool. I guess we'll just keep on hammering them. We just need to overrun this unit. You guys are still shooting? Yeah, you still have ammo. I don't know what you guys are up to. I mean, you just charge in there. We're kind of close to winning this right-hand side. Our general is fully engaged, so we'll try and inspire one of our more elite units. And yeah, these elves here are out of ammo. Are just fully stuck in here on the front line. You can see the soldiers getting brought down. So I just need to turn the sound up a little bit. I think it's a little bit too quiet. Music can go off, obviously, but we'll turn up this a little bit more. Retreat! No retreat, no surrender. Let's also actually... That's good. Let's actually break our formation now, then. The fact that we've broken by general is obviously a great sign. Let's get our light swords around the side. And I guess I'll also go and close off their retreat over here. Fear no darkness. And yeah, we'll wrap around here. And we'll just try and finish off this Caliphate cavalry. We can see how strong the Harad cavalry is. They've been able to, you know, basically engage my back line very effectively. And just still fighting spears and doing a good job. Obviously, when their general breaks, though, that's not going to be good. So, pop a rally as well. Why not? And if we can, second wind as well. Because as you can see, Shogun 2 is a game where the battles are very fast. Like, really, really fast. So a lot of the time, you do actually end up, you know, getting very tired soldiers very quickly. So any ability that gives you the soldiers their vigor back, their energy back, it is absolutely huge. It really is. Seeing some of the Axemen now fighting. And the archer fire coming into the back of these guys again, just trying to break them. Oh, cavalry's done a good job here. Let's just charge for cavalry in. Let's get a nice little cavalry charge here. Right into their back. And that should be a big shock as well. Cavalry is super strong in Shogun 2, from what I remember. Yeah, and they just mass route, basically. Yeah, nice. Elves strong. Also, another really exciting thing about this mod being developed and when it may be a bit more fleshed out is that there can be drop-in battles as well. If you guys don't know, back in the day in Shogun 2, you could actually drop into someone's campaign and play a battle, which, you know, can sound like it might have its issues, but I think for the most part it was a great feature. And something that, you know, I'd love to see back in more recent Total Wars, because the AI is arguably, or not arguably, is the worst part of any Total War game. So having a player kind of jump in, obviously they could be really annoying and troll you and, you know, do horrible stuff like that, but I think there's plenty of ways they could sort that out with like rating systems and stuff, I don't know. But for the most part, that'd be so fun to do that in like more recent Total War games. You know, playing on a stream and just having you guys fight in. But my point is that when this mod gets a bit more developed and maybe they add in the forces of Gondor, Rohan, or the second age equivalent of Gondor and Rohan, I think they're the Caledoria, I can't remember their names, and Mordor, I'll definitely do some campaigns and we can do some drop-in battles live on stream. It'll be really, really fun. Yeah, you guys can see the strength of some of these Elven units. The archers is going to town, 400 kills. Even the Light Axemen doing good. The Elves are going to be a very, very strong faction indeed. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to drop a like and a comment down below. Let me know if you're going to be picking up this this new patch for The Last Alliance. If you're going to be messing around with it, I'd be very interested to see what you guys are you thought of it. And if you have any opinions as well, put them all down below in the comments. What faction are you most looking forward to as well? Let me know about that. And make sure you join the Discord. Make sure you check out my ModDB page. And I'll see you guys in the next one.